In this FormAssembly and Salesforce tutorial, I'll walk you through how to use FormAssembly to quickly and easily build a powerful Salesforce-connected web form. Hi, I'm Dustin Phelps with FormAssembly. FormAssembly's powerful Salesforce integration allows you to update existing leads, create new leads, or create a different object altogether. To put it simply, FormAssembly helps you save time on leads management and cut down on duplicate data. By using web forms on your website, you can easily capture information about your visitors and turn them into new leads for your organization. FormAssembly makes it easier than ever to create web-to-lead forms and send important lead data to Salesforce, where your lead can be scored, qualified, and nurtured. In order to follow this tutorial, you'll need a FormAssembly account and a Salesforce professional account or higher. If you don't have a FormAssembly account already, it's easy to get started. Just pause this video and head on over to formassembly.com/signup to start a free 14-day trial. You don't need a credit card to sign up. Our first step is to create our form. I'm in the FormAssembly list dashboard. From here, you can create a new form by navigating over to the New Form button in the left sidebar. You can also open the Salesforce Web2Lead template in FormAssembly's template library by clicking Template Library in the left sidebar and scrolling down to the Web2Lead template, or you can simply search for it. You will want to make sure your Web2Lead form has all the necessary fields that make sense for your lead capturing. In this tutorial, we're using first and last name, email, and company. If you'd like to customize your form, go ahead and do that now. I'm going to use the default Arctic Air theme, which I can easily access from the Themes tab. We can also customize these themes, but more on that in another tutorial. After you've built and customized your Web2Lead form, it's time to navigate to the connector page in FormAssembly. To find this page, select the connector icon on the left sidebar. If you are in the Forms List page, you can hover over Configure and then Connectors in the drop-down menu of the form you want to set up. We're going to add and configure our Salesforce connector. We can check to make sure we're in the correct form by looking at the title of the form at the top of the page. Add a Salesforce connector under the Form Submitted step by clicking Add Connector for Form Submission. Connectors added to the Form Submitted step will process the moment a form is submitted. We also have connectors that can be activated when a form opens and after a form has been submitted. After clicking Add Connector for Form Submission, scroll down and select the Salesforce connector, then click Configure. If you use the Salesforce Web2Lead template, one will be set up for you already. All you have left to do is review and authenticate it. If you're setting up your connector for the first time, you'll be prompted to set up your Salesforce connection. I prefer using the single sign-on method because it's the easiest way to get set up. You can also connect to Salesforce with a security token if you prefer. To find or reset your security token, go to your Salesforce account, navigate to Settings, My Personal Information, and then Reset My Security Token. Begin by selecting Connect to Salesforce, unless you're using a sandbox account or a custom domain, in which case you would select the appropriate option. Once you've selected Connect to Salesforce, you'll be automatically redirected to sign into Salesforce and then the Salesforce authentication page. After entering your Salesforce credentials, you'll be asked to allow access to FormAssembly. Click on Allow, and you'll be automatically redirected back to FormAssembly. Once you've returned to the connector setup page, you'll see that your Salesforce access has been configured to the credentials you just entered. You can change this access at any time by clicking on the Change Access button. Now select Enable. Next, we'll select an object. Click Select your first object. Now, we can see that by using the first dropdown, we are telling the connector to create something. And since we want to create a lead, we can use the second dropdown to select lead. Now we're ready to start mapping our fields. You can see that the required fields for the object you choose will automatically populate. This left column shows us what fields in Salesforce need data for this object. The two columns to the right give us the option of how and where we get that information. In this case, we just want to pull the data from our form and the corresponding form fields. These are pulled from the form field labels, so it's important to make sure your form fields are labeled clearly and correctly. If you'd like to add additional fields, click Map Another Field. For example, if we also wanted to pull in a new lead's email address, we could, as long as it's a field that we have in our form. But for this tutorial, we will just go ahead with the company and last name fields. Now all you need to do is save your connector. After clicking the Save button, you're done setting up your Salesforce connector. All there's left to do now is to start using your web-to-lead form. To do this, go to the Publish page by clicking Publish in the left toolbar and click the link to go to your form. Fill out the form, click Submit, and within a few seconds, you should see the new data in your Salesforce account. If you'd like, you can also review the Salesforce connector log. Once you've confirmed that the form is properly connected, your web-to-lead form is ready to go. Hundreds of Salesforce users build web-to-lead forms with FormAssembly to simplify their lead management processes. Our all-in-one web form builder and data collection platform connects seamlessly to Salesforce, allowing you to update or create almost any type of record. To learn even more about FormAssembly's Salesforce Connector, visit formassembly.com/Salesforce. We hope this video helps you streamline your lead management processes. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with others. Also, be sure to subscribe to our channel for more great content. Thanks for watching. We'll be right back.